CNN viewers were shocked when they saw what aired across their TV during live attack broadcast. Controversy surrounding the media is nothing new in this day and age. Almost everyone has an opinion about what we should believe and why. The president has gotten bad press, essentially because he says that the press is bad. Of course, not the concept of the press, but the mainstream media who continually seems to have an agenda. Their attacks on the president didn't go unnoticed, and the general public is finally realizing that we are being lied to by major networks a lot more than many of us previously realized. Many think that the president launched a war on the media when he started his political career, but that's not the case. He launched a war on the lies that the media tells. Some overtly, and some just because of the way they present the facts, but lies all the same. Waging a war on something that is bad for the American people is what a president is supposed to do, and President Trump is taking it very seriously. That war has empowered many who consider the truth to be a lost cause. Calling out the media has given power back to the people, and they love it. They love it so much that they've been emboldened to stand up for themselves, like the man in the video below. Daily Mail reports that CNN superstar reporter Anderson Cooper was covering the recent terrorist attacks in NYC when one lied to and disgruntled American took a stand. Protesters interrupted a live CNN broadcast from the scene of the New York terror attack on Tuesday night to chant fake news. Microphones picked up on the group's shouts as Anderson Cooper attempted to cover the Manhattan attack, which killed 8 and wounded 12. At another point, a man made his way into the back of the shot while holding a banner which reads "CNN is ISIS." The protester may seem like he's taking a huge stand, but in reality, he's just reiterating what his president has to say about the news giant. By this point, anyone who is truly looking for the truth and paying any attention at all has enough irrefutable proof that the media is a propaganda machine to convince them. There are still a lot who just want to have their own beliefs confirmed, but that's not a search for truth, that's more of a search for confirmation of their own feelings. While most would agree that CNN could well fall under the fake news, the accusation that they're part of ISIS is a pretty serious one. While most wouldn't put it outside of their moral compass, it's a very big accusation for many reasons. Here are a few more details about the attack from our source. The terror group had also issued a propaganda leaflet earlier on Tuesday calling for attacks that evening, though it had featured a picture of the Eiffel Tower rather than New York. Saipov drove 17 blocks down a cycle path in Lower Manhattan in a rented Home Depot truck before swerving back onto a highway and slamming into a school bus. He then jumped out of the vehicle waving fake guns before he was shot in the stomach by a night officer and arrested. Pro-ISIS channels on social media have also been praising Saipov and describing him as a brother. The terror group had also issued a propaganda leaflet earlier on Tuesday calling for attacks that evening, though it had featured a picture of the Eiffel Tower rather than New York. Saipov drove 17 blocks down a cycle path in Lower Manhattan in a rented Home Depot truck before swerving back onto a highway and slamming into a school bus. He then jumped out of the vehicle waving fake guns before he was shot in the stomach by a night officer and arrested.